In this video, I'm gonna do another t-shirt design tutorial. More specifically, this one right here. You can see it has a retro vibe. It's got wavy lines and it's got this cool 70s style. I'm gonna show you how to do it all in Affinity Designer. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I'm gonna do another t-shirt design tutorial. And this one's gonna be all in Affinity Designer. I've noticed a lot of retro designs out there lately on Amazon, on Redbubble, everywhere. I'm gonna show you how to do this one right here. You can see it has the wavy lines and some flowers and things like that. It's very simple to do. Of course, you can make it even more detailed if you wanted to, but I'm gonna keep it really simple in this video. At first, I'm gonna show you the font. The font's very important. You're gonna wanna get a retro font. I'll show you where I get this one. This one's a free font. And I'm gonna show you how to curve the lines as well as make the flowers in Affinity Designer. So we're gonna do all of that in this video. First, let's go to the internet and find our fonts. So here we are on the internet. I went to dafont.com. You can see dafont.com. This is where you can get a lot of free fonts. There's lots of places to get fonts, but this is one place to get the free ones, and you have to find one that says 100% commercial free. And you can see some of these say for personal use only. Don't do that if you're gonna put it on t-shirts. You can do that for fun for yourself, but if you're gonna put it on t-shirts, you can't do it. So one way that's really easy on DaFont is to find a 70s font, and you can see right here it says Groovy. So just click on that, Groovy. And you can see some of these are really good, and again, for personal use. So one way to find out which ones to use is to hit more options and do 100% free. So not personal use, not donationware, not any of these. 100% free, and then hit submit. And now we can use these. You can see all of these say 100% free. And then we can just go down here and use whatever font we want. You're gonna have to download it. But just look at some of these. Some of these are really good. I love this Prisma one right here. Disco Diva is a great one. Some of these, I mean, you might want to download a bunch of these, right? But for this tutorial, let's go ahead and just download one of them. Let's do Coaster. So right here, come to Coaster. This is the one I'm going to use. There's both black and shadow. So we're not going to use the shadow, but that's a cool one to use as well. You could probably color in and have that shadow. So just hit download. Upload it to your computer, and we're gonna put it into Affinity Designer and go from there. All right, so here we are in Affinity Designer. The first thing we're gonna do is type out our words. I usually like having three words in this case, or at least three lines. So you can have multiple words on each line if you want to, but just for the sake of this tutorial, three lines would be easy. You could do it with four lines. You could do it with however many lines, two lines, but just for this tutorial. So. Let's see, I'm going to type in the word just and make it bigger here and make sure we use the right font. Remember, it was Coaster. Let me go to my regular all here and Coaster right there. Just the one we signed. I'm going to use all caps. So hold down that caps lock, just. And then if you use this trick, holding down option, clicking on here and then dragging, you can see you can make multiple, just a copy of it. So I'm just gonna do just stay groovy. All right, very easy so far. Make every one of these the size that you want. So I want maybe this one that size and this one that size, something like that, right? Now, if they're too far apart, what you can do is come in here, hold down option as well and click on the left arrow, and you can see we can move it in. Same thing here, move it in. I want this one as well. So kind of just scooch everything closer together if you want to. All right, great. And now make it as big as, you know, as we want it to, just the right size. I think that's great. Okay. So the very next thing we're gonna do is start drawing some lines, some wavy lines, and this is gonna help us when we wanna make the bottom or the top of the letters curvy. So we're just gonna do our pen tool right here and just come in here and just do whatever we want. So come in here, drag it, and go like that. See what I did there? So it's just a line. And if you go to color, make it black so you can see it. Now you may not want it that thick. It's just for guides. So come in here, make it 1 point, 2 point, something like that. Now you want to put this right about where you want the bottom of just to be. So let's say that's just, you can copy this again, hold down option, click on the line, and then move it down. And so this will be where the top of stay will be. You can see how that works. And then if you want the same thing down here, you can copy that again, but you could make a different one. You could do, have it come like this, and then maybe this one's down like that. That's fine too. In fact, I think that's better to give it, even more, so it's not the same. You got more variety here, right? So come in here, and if this isn't curvy enough, you can come back and grab these handles and be like, I want that even more curvy, right? And then hold down option and then copy it again like that. Now put this where you want it to be. So if you want it to be kind of like that, then that's where you do it. So those are going to be your guidelines to move these. And so there's no real easy way to do this. We're going to have to come in here and move the lines. I'll show you how to do that. There's no like quick button, but I'm going to show you how to do it. It takes a little time and patience, but it turns out really good. So let me show you the next step. All right, so I took this. This is for what I did previously, these lines. They're a little thinner. You can see they're just 0.2. They're just really guides. The next thing you're going to want to do is convert these to curves. So hit this, convert to curves, and then hit ungroup. You're going to want to do this for every one of these. So convert to curves, ungroup, convert to curves, ungroup. And then we're just going to move the letters just slightly right now to fit where they're gonna be. So you can see the line, so this S should be touching this one and that one, right? And this J should be touching that one. And don't move the top here for the just, we want that straight. So let's just move these just so they're the same height as kind of where we want it to be. So this isn't perfect yet, but this is just gonna get us close. So move that and that. And you can see it's getting us pretty close to where we want to be, but not exactly where we want to be, but because we want it to curve even more. And you can see some of these aren't really following the line. So the ones that aren't following the line, we're going to come in here and we're going to get in closer. So let's move in, zoom in here, and just make sure that it follows the line. So now that it's ungrouped or curves, we can come in here and click on these lines here and just kind of follow this. So if we wanted to have it follow the line, we can come in here and kind of move it. You can see I can move this line here and so on. Now if some lines dots get in the way, you can just delete it, make your own line. The nice thing about these retro fonts is they're really nice to manipulate, because when you move things around, they still kind of keep their look instead of being just so rigid. So you can see when I zoom out here, it still kind of keeps it. And maybe you want to not come it right at the angle here. Maybe you want to make it just a little bit more soft. Maybe it comes down like that and just touches it. So you can move things around, kind of play with it. You're just changing the look of it. So I'm going to go in here and do the same thing. The T is like one that you really need to do. So let me show you that first. Because it has a long straight edge, this is the one that's going to give the illusion that it's all curving, right? So if we do that and come in here, anything with a long straight edge, these are the ones that are going to help give that look that it's curving. So if we come back here, you can see that T, and then we're going to do the bottom here too. So that's how you do it in Affinity Designer. You can see it didn't take me that long to do it. I'm going to finish all these letters right here, and I'll come back and I'll show you what happens. All right, so here we're back. Now you can see I followed the lines right here. I made that T, this T down here. Now if when you did it, this S was further out like this, you can just move it in closer and then make sure that it's back on the line, okay? So just eyeball it. You're gonna kinda eyeball all these fonts here and you can see they're just following the line. So of course you're gonna move those lines away before you put it on a t-shirt. So let's just click on it and delete it. And you can see right there. And if you want to make these closer, you know, just they're all independent now. So you can make it closer if you want or whatever. The next thing I'm going to show you is how to make the flowers. Now, I actually have a video on how to do all of these. So click on this video up top right here if you want to see all of them. I'm just going to show you a real easy one first. So click on this right here. This is the star tool. It's under your triangle tool. You click on the star. And then there's going to be this box right here. Presets. So there's a bunch of preset flowers. You can just click on here. Look at that. Hold down shift. And then you can go to color, color it whatever color you want. So you want kind of those orange browns, I think, and blues. And then you can put a circle in between here. So let's hold down shift with the circle. You know, maybe it's pink or something. Yeah. And then click on both of these and then make sure that they're aligned horizontally and vertically, and then you can group them. All right, so there's one flower. Use that video to show you how to make a bunch of other flowers. There's a bunch of other presets, a bunch of other things that you can do with the tool. All the tools you need to make the flowers are right here. So you can come in here, do the star tool, do some of the other tools. I think the cog tool was some of the other ones. Watch that video and you can see how to do all the flowers that I put in here. All right, so here we got a bunch of flowers that I picked from that video and put it on here. And the next thing we want to do is color. So let's click on the artboard. We want to see what it looks like on a dark shirt first. So let me do just like that. It's like a dark gray. Make sure that these can be seen. So let's just change them to white for now. And white. And that right there is pretty cool too. But if you want to follow a 70s color palette, you can go look for a 70s color palette. They usually use like muted colors. So let me show you what I'm thinking, like an orange, like a red. So let me do like a, you know, they usually use kind of like that or kind of like a lighter one, right? Maybe sometimes like a pink. Could do that. And then like a blue, like a green blue. Something like that. Now, maybe one more color, like a yellow. Cool. So that's just off the top of my head. And of course, you want to make everything around it about the same color. So if you come in here, you want to pick that same orange, right? Just to have the same color palette. And so this yellow, now this light yellow should be this light yellow, and so on. I did one earlier. I'll show you just like this, where it's all the same color palette. Now, this looks really cool, like this, with all the different colors. And it does look cool on black. But the thing you'll have to remember is if you want to put it on different colors, it may not work. So if we change the background of this right here to red, you can kind of see that it kind of gets lost, this red right here. But if we change the background here to like green, you know, it kind of works. So it's tough to know what green and what blue and things are going to be used on the background. You can use that thing that I did that I have the free download for the background t-shirts for Amazon, but it may not work for all colors for Redbubble and all those things too. So one thing that I would suggest is you could do it this way with the cool colors for every letter. One thing I would suggest is maybe do, you know, one word one color, the other word another color, and so on. And this is a lot easier to read when you're doing a background like red or something like that, or you come in here and, you know, the background is purple or something. That's a lot easier to read than trying to do the different colors. It's your choice which way you want to go. And then, of course, I would do a white background as well. So if you just do white, just change the color so that they're darker on here. So that's how you do that design. One last thing I'm gonna show you is how to put the vintage texture on it, and it's super easy. So let me show you how to do that right now. So we're back in Affinity Designer. I have a texture right here. I have a video on textures and how to do the texture. So if you wanna click on that video right here, I'll put it in the description as well. A full tutorial on how to do it, but I'll show you where, in that video, I'll show you where to find this and where to find textures. Let's just say you have a texture already right here. So you can see this is right there. I'm gonna click on my artboard. You can see this whole thing is grouped, right? Like that. So I'm gonna put this above it right here. So you can see in my artboard, this group and the texture. So I'm gonna group both of these right there. Now you can see in the group, there's the texture and the group. So all I need to do on the texture now is come here and go down to erase. And you can see it erased it from the background. There's that cool texture. And if I put the different colors of the background, let's say that it's light yellow instead, you can see it's showing through. So let me zoom in. See that? It's just showing right through. So that erase is erasing that texture from the back, from the design, from the graphic, right? There you go. Really cool. So this is our simple, very simple design. Of course, you can put the flowers any way, color the flowers, use different words, curve your thing a different way, right? I just curved it this way, but you could come in the other way or whatever and make it different. Use four lines, use three lines, use different words, use different fonts even. This font's really cool, very easy to adjust. So you can see it has that flow to it. If you're gonna use like straight fonts, it might be a little harder, but this just has a nice look to it. So this is your 70s groovy tutorial. Have fun with this, go and make more designs and hopefully get more sales. So that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you. And if you don't wanna just put flowers in there, go search online. You can put things like mushrooms and rainbows and other groovy things and 70 things, retro things. There's lots of graphics out there. I just did flowers because that's something you can actually do in Affinity Designer. But if you wanna add more graphics to it, I think it will really help sell the retro-ness of it. So have fun with this one. If this video is really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, what other graphics would you put in this besides flowers? Let me know that in the comments if you can think of different things. It'd be really cool to kind of upgrade it, you know, to make it look even better. So thanks again for watching. Hopefully this tutorial is really helpful for you. If you want to see more design tutorials, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.